Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing well. So in today's video, I'm going to share all my makeup and skincare empties. I've used these products completely and now I have formed an opinion on whether I like the product or not, whether I'm going to repurchase it or not. So if you want to see my thoughts on these products, then please keep on watching. So let's start with my regular skincare. I've finished two of these Himalaya Fresh Start face wash. This is in the blueberry variant and this is the strawberry variant. So there's no difference in these face wash except their color, their fragrance, and yeah, that's it. So if you have preference for strawberry, go for this. If you have preference for blueberry, go for this. They are completely same, they just have different packaging and different color. So yeah, they are normal standard Himalaya face wash. I love them for regular use. They actually clean your face. Like, I have oily skin, so it's perfect to, you know, remove all the oil and dirt and just make my skin breathable. So for basic face wash purpose, these are really good. I recommend, and you can definitely buy any variant of Himalaya face washes. They're all very nice, very standard, and yeah, you can never go wrong with them. The next thing which I finished is this Garnier Micellar Water, and this is in the pink variant, and it is 125 ml of product, and it was really a nice micellar water. Like, it did its job very well. It removed makeup, it didn't you know, burn my skin or anything of that sort. So it was easy. Like, you could use this on your eyes also. It was gentle. It's a nice product. Like, if you're looking for a budget friendly micellar water, this is the one to go. I don't think I'm gonna repurchase the Garnier one, simply because I have two bottles of Bioderma micellar water and it works just as fine, so I don't have a need to purchase. So yeah, you could just, if you're looking for an affordable cleansing water which will do its job, you can go for this one. Another thing from Himalaya is this Cocoa Butter Intensive Body Lotion. This is 100 ml, and this is again one of the very iconic lotions from Himalaya. Like, a lot of people I know use this, and it's a decent body lotion again, nothing very fancy. It smells like chocolate and it's really thick, so it's not recommended to use in summer unless you have a very dry skin. So yeah, it's a basic lotion for your skin and legs, and I quite liked it. I have 2-3 bottles of this, so I am going to use it. So yeah, that's, so talking about body lotions, I also finished the Body Shop Cocoa Butter body lotion. This I had used up in winter months and I just had kept the bottle to show you guys in the video. So again, this is very moisturizing body lotion. If you have a very dry skin, and especially in winter months, you can definitely try this. It is very moisturizing and it just locks in the moisture in your skin for a very long time, and I love it. And I love Body Shop products anyway, so I'm definitely going to buy this maybe in winter months, not right now, because right now I'm using their Cherry Blossom body butter and I really like that. So yeah, a nice purchase from Body Shop. So from Body Shop, I have used up their strawberry lip balm. This is their old packaging, now they have another packaging. So yeah, it's completely gone. This took a really long time to finish, maybe just because I have 2-3 lip balms going on at the same time. But yeah, I finally finished this and I'm really happy. It's a very fruity smelling lip balm and I love how it smells and how it hydrates my lips. I like to wear it under liquid lipsticks or just like that when my lips are dehydrated and dry. So it's a nice one, you can definitely try it. So I've already bought another strawberry lip balm from Body Shop, so yeah, I would definitely repurchase this. So the next thing which I have is this Innisfree White Tone Cream, and the packaging is also gone. I had this since a very long time and I've completely used this up. It's gone, done, empty. And yeah, it's a very lightweight cream. Since I have oily skin, I'm very fussy about the kind of moisturizer I pick for my skin, because if it's very heavy, I don't like it. And this was a lightweight cream and it you know, moisturized and hydrated my face very well. This product claims to give you white tone or brightness, but I didn't see any visible difference. So I wouldn't recommend for that. But if you're looking for a good moisturizer for oily skin, which is light on your skin and keeps your skin healthy, then definitely you can go for it. I won't repurchase it because I have few other moisturizers which I'm liking better. So I won't repurchase it, but it's not a bad product. Yeah. So next thing which I've finished is this Innisfree capsule rice pack. So this was a sleeping pack, and you're supposed to put this pack on your face and keep it overnight. So you wake up with baby soft skin, and it actually did it. I really like it. And the best thing is, if you keep this in the freezer and then apply it, you get that cooling spa like feel. So I absolutely love it. So if there are any offers on Nykaa, you can definitely pick few of these and keep. They are really good. They retail for 150 rupees, and yeah, that's how it looks. It's completely gone, and yeah, I would definitely repurchase it. I've used a lot of Innisfree skincare, I think last couple of months. So I got a set, green tea set, free with a purchase, and yeah, these are the two products. This is the Innisfree Aloe Revival Sleeping Pack. Again, I love the formula of their sleeping packs. They are very gel-like and hydrating, and it doesn't make your skin oily or it doesn't break your skin out. So it's definitely good for oily skin types. So if you're looking for a good, you know, sleeping packs, definitely try Innisfree. So again, this is completely gone. Okay, and yeah, this came in some set, so I don't know, I can link them. But yeah, and this is the green tea balancing cream. I finished this up while I was traveling. It's completely gone. I like these sample sizes to, you know, carry in my bag or in my travel kit if I'm traveling. They are like of good quality, and it doesn't, you know, take up much space, so it was nice. The other thing which I finished from Innisfree is this Jeju Volcanic color clay mask. Again, this was free with purchase. This is a sample size, and I liked using it, but I didn't see any difference, and I don't even remember what this is for, because it doesn't say what it'll do to your skin. It just says Jeju Volcanic color clay mask. So I used to just apply on my pores, leave it for 15-20 minutes, and then rinse it off. So I just felt good that I'm doing something for my skin, but I didn't see any difference. So personally, I wouldn't recommend to buy this. Like, if you're looking for a clay mask, there are other options in the market, you can definitely try them. This is just unnecessarily overpriced, and it doesn't do anything. So yeah, that's that. Then I finished this Biotique Bio Papaya scrub. It's for tan removal, and it's completely gone. The bottle is disgusting. I really liked it. It's a very nice scrub, but you have to be careful that you are gentle while scrubbing, because it can get a little harsh if you don't take care. It's not good to scrub your skin very harshly, so you have to be careful. But it does what it says. It removes tan, and it just instantly brightens your skin and clears your pores and all of that. So yeah, and it just retails for 200 rupees. So this is like a steal purchase. If you're looking for some detan product for your skin, definitely try this out. And in summers, you definitely need to have one of these. So I'm going to definitely repurchase this, and you can definitely try it if you're looking for a detan scrub. Next thing which we have is this Inathur shower gel. This is their pomegranate shower gel, and it's sulfate free, and it has raspberry and black pepper. So frankly speaking, I just finished this up. I didn't like it that much, because as it says, it's sulfate free. It doesn't foam that much, so you have to really use lot of the product to get that foam which you usually get in your normal shower gels. So it's a nice product if you have sensitive skin and you don't want to use sulfate for your skin, but it doesn't give that luxurious rich foam which I usually crave for. So yeah, it's a nice product, but I wouldn't repurchase it. Another shower gel which I have is this Coco Flamingo. I'm sorry, the bottle is really dented because I've squeezed out every last bit of the product. I love this shower gel. It smells amazing. It has a coconutty scent and it just reminds you of a tropical beach vacation. And I got this from Dubai and I absolutely love it. It smells nice. It's very creamy, very rich. It says it's super creamy, and it definitely is very creamy and very luxurious and very nice. And I absolutely loved using this. It's not available in India, so if I travel abroad and I happen to find this, I will definitely repurchase it. So yeah, and it looked also very pretty, but now it's all dead. So now coming to makeup. So I've finished quite a few makeup products and I'm excited to show it to you. So the first thing is number 7, Airbrush Away Primer. So I'd bought this product again when I was in Dubai. I'd got a number 7 set and it had this primer and it was really nice. It was very lotiony, so it just gave a nice moisturizing base for your foundation and for your makeup. So I didn't necessarily see any difference in my pores, but it just gave a very smooth base for makeup, which I liked, and I finished it. I don't think I'll repurchase it just because this is not available in India, and it wasn't like super wow that I'll go out of my way and purchase it again. The other thing which I finished is this Nykaa Skin Genius foundation. I was in the shade 03 Warm Honey. I absolutely love Nykaa foundation, especially this range. I know they just have 5 colors in this range and you may not find your color, but if you do, it's a very nice formula. It's very hydrating and I used to use this a lot in winters because, you know, if you have dry skin and patchy skin, foundation doesn't look good. But if you have a hydrating foundation, it just makes it better and natural looking. So I loved it. And yeah, it's very lightweight and it just gives a very natural coverage, so for that I love it, and I already have a backup of it, so definitely try this. So the next product which I have is this Maybelline New York compact powder. It's the white super fresh. I finished it completely. It's in a very bad state. The mirror broke and I don't know, it's been for a very long time and I finally finished it, and I'm so happy I'm done with the powder because makeup takes really very long to finish. I love buying makeup but I can't finish it. So when you finish a product, you feel really very good. So I'm really happy that I finished this product, and I don't think I'm gonna repurchase it because I'm just trying to buy cruelty free makeup. Like, at least when I buy makeup, I want to buy cruelty free. If I get it in PR or if I get it as a gift, it's like, okay, I can't do anything. At least if when I go out and buy products, I want it to be cruelty free. Unfortunately, Maybelline is not cruelty free, so I won't be buying any products from them from now on. So yeah, I've finished that. The next thing which I finished is this liquid lipstick. This is from Makeup Revolution and it's in the shade Noble. Actually, this came in a set with a lip pencil, so that's why it doesn't have any name. I don't remember the thing, but it had a black packaging, that much I remember. It was a set with liquid lipstick and a lip pencil. This is completely gone. I used to love this lipstick. It's a beautiful nude color. It's just very effortless and I love the formula also. It was not very drying, or it didn't, you know, make my lips look all dry and ugly. So yeah, I love the formula, but as you can see, I have a lot of lipsticks. I don't think I need to go out and repurchase it, but someday maybe I will buy if I run out of my new lipsticks. I will link the set in the description box below, so if you are looking for it, you can definitely check it out. And the last product is this what do you call eyeliner from the brand called Bonjour Paris. It's completely gone. So I don't know, I have a very bad experience with felt tip eyeliners. As far as I remember, all the eyeliners which I've bought, at least the felt tip ones, have dried up very quickly on me. So this also went away very quickly. I don't know, maybe I'm storing it wrong or it's not closing properly, but I don't know, it's just I don't have luck with felt tip liners, so it just dries away very quickly. But it's a very affordable one if you're looking for a nice eyeliner. When it was working, it was really very black and pigmented and it was smooth to apply, but it just ran away very quickly. So I don't know if I'll repurchase it. Let's see. So yeah, that's it for my makeup empties. I hope you all enjoyed it. So please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give this video a big thumbs up. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.